Welcome to all of you, and thanks for coming to celebrate this with us. Now, you are not here merely as spectators. You don't get to just sit there and watch Stephen dance. You are here as people with whom Stephen and Allyson wish to share the beginning of their lives together as husband and wife. Some of you are family, some are friends, some of you are dance partners, some are colleagues or co-workers, but all of you are important parts in the lives of Stephen and Allyson. They hope that the relationships they've developed with you will continue and strengthen during their years together as husband and wife. And Stephen and Allyson, as you know, this ceremony is of great importance to your family and friends who've waited years for this, as well as those who could not attend because of distance or illness. By sharing this ceremony with them, you've underscored their importance in your lives, and in their presence, you're making your vows in dedication to a lasting union that should endure for the rest of your lives. Now, I'll probably seem a little nervous today. That's because my wife is in the front row and threatens me. If I tell any jokes, I'm going to get in trouble. So after she told me that, I had to cut my remarks in about half. So it'll be a quick ceremony. So if I seem nervous, it's my wife's fault. Now, the ceremony that we're going to perform today is fairly short and fairly simple. The specific words, of course, aren't important. What is important, in fact, what's paramount, are the love, affection, and respect Stephen and Allyson have for each other and which they share with us today. They're here to affirm their love in this union. They do so with full knowledge that marriage represents the most tender and precious of relationships. And Stephen and Allyson, you should resolve to nurture the cherish the love, trust, and esteem each of you holds for the other today. Remember that the foundation of this marriage is not just the love you feel for each other today, but the love you will feel in the years and days to come. And remember also, marriage is a partnership, a joining together of two separate individuals. There should be room for each other's variety and unique characteristics in the marriage. You don't want to lose the gifts that attracted you one to the other. We probably should turn to some of our ceremonial duties. First, a reminder. Those of us in attendance today are present to witness a statement of lasting love and commitment between Stephen and Allyson. You were invited to this ceremony because you have played a special role in their lives. You're present to celebrate their marriage and to witness their vows of love to each other. So I have for our guests a question, and I want a response. Will all of you gathered here today do all in your power to support and love this couple now and in the years ahead? And if you will, please say, we will.
We will.
Once more.
We will.
One more.
We will.
Okay, that's good. Thank you.
Stephen, I love how you always live life like no one's watching, even though you know I am, probably with a funny look on my face. You're a character in your own right, and maybe that's why I love spending time with you so much. You quote movies, often incorrectly, and you practice character accents, definitely incorrectly, but you do your thing and you keep life entertaining. I will say your choice to channel Nacho Libre when we're fighting is questionable though, and it's always really risky. But that said, it's been 10 years and whatever we've got going on here works. Your chill attitude is contagious and reminds me daily that life is way bigger than caring about small inconvenient things like not getting breadsticks in my Domino's order or having to share a bathroom in our new house. And speaking of, I can't wait to move into our new house. Looking for a house in Seattle was one of the most stressful things, and even though I was 99% discouraged, your optimism helped land us where we are today, buying a house and getting married in the same freaking week. You bring the carefree and calm to our relationship, so it made me wonder what that leaves for me to bring to it, and I'm sure you're gonna tell me in a second. But what I do promise to keep bringing is my never-ending request to get you to stay up past your bedtime and to go on spontaneous trips with me, even though you say it costs too much money. Stephen, you're my favorite person in the world, and I promise to be the best wife I can be because you're the best person that I know.
My nuptial, unequivocally playful, endearingly sassy Allyson. You have been the most challenging, difficult, pressing, emotional, wonderful, genuinely happy part of my life. You've always been uniquely yourself, and you follow your own code and lifestyle in a way that inspires me to be better. You've helped me through tough times, both in school and work, and you always challenge me to achieve what I want to do in life with no regard to how it impacts you. There's no doubt that I would not be where I am today without you. While planning your proposal, I had to do one of the most difficult things I've ever done. I had to keep a secret from you for over a month. You are the most inquisitive person I know, and I was terrified you would figure out what I was doing before I was able to propose. Luckily, I was able to keep the secret, and the proposal was a success. After thinking about how you always seemed to figure me out, I wanted to know what I was doing wrong. And I came up with a better reason than I'm just a lousy sneak, or that you have the makings of a great CIA agent. It's simply because I want to share everything with my best friend, and it's something I got to do now. I vow to love and support you to my fullest capability, to take on new challenges as they arrive, and always look at you first as my partner in decision making. I vow to continue dancing, laughing, and even making fun of horror movies just so I can hide behind you when I get scared. I vow to continue to grow with you, to challenge you, and to carry on our journey together as we take this path now as husband and wife. You are the love of my life, and I'm so excited to get married.
So by the authority vested in me as a judge of the Superior Court of the State of Washington, I now pronounce you husband and wife, and you may kiss the bride or the groom.
Shuffling.
Shuffling, shuffling. Step up fast and be
be the first girl to make me throw this cash. We get money, don't be mad, now stop. Hating is bad. One more shot for us, another round. Please fill up my cup, don't mess around. We just want to see you shake it up. Now you home with me. You're naked now.
Get up, get down, put your hands up to the sun. Get up, get down, put your hands up to the sun.